Welcome! In this video, you will learn how to introspect a Postgres database to generate a Prisma data model. For this demo, I'm using a Postgres database that's running on my local machine. You can see here in Postico that it has two tables, called User and Post. Note that the Post table has a foreign key pointing to User called AuthorID. In Prisma, this relationship between User and Post will be represented as a one-to-many relation. Before I run the introspection, I need to tell Prisma where to find my database. In this case, I'm setting the database connection URL as an environment variable inside the .env file and point it to a local Postgres server that's running on my machine. With the connection URL in place, I can now run the Prisma introspect command. The introspection overwrites my current schema file by inserting the Prisma data model it obtained during introspection. The data model is a declarative representation of my database schema and defines my application models. These models will be picked up by Prisma Client, which will expose queries that are tailored to these models. Now, as you can see, the introspection added one model for each table to my Prisma schema. Also note that there is a relation between the two models, represented by two relation fields on each side. And as a last thing in this video, I will rename a few of the generated fields to make the Prisma Client API, which is generated from the schema, a bit nicer to use. The fields on my Prisma models will appear in the Prisma Client API, so I want the names to adhere to typical naming conventions in JavaScript and TypeScript, such as camel casing, variable, and property names. The field that represents the relation to the user model on post gets renamed to author to add a little bit more meaning to the relation between the two models. Additionally, the post field gets renamed to posts because it actually represents a list of post objects, so using plural form feels more appropriate. That's it for this video. In the next video, you will learn how to generate Prisma Client and use it to send your first query to your database from TypeScript.